Hello. Today we are going to make a flag of Sweden. Inflate a balloon leaving about 8-inch flat tail. Basically, we are going to use the same technique as described in previously published instruction Fabric 6, Flex 2. Today we have to make two squares and two rectangles. So let's make the square piece first. Twist a chain of four bubbles. For this sculpture we have to twist all bubbles of the same size, up to 1 inch. Here we made a chain of four bubbles. Let's lock both ends of the chain of the first four bubbles in one lock twist. We have made a square. We are going to build a bigger size square around this small square. Twist a chain of the next three bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last four, or the last six bubbles, in one lock twist. We have to force the end of the balloon through the loop of the chain of the first four bubbles. We have made one corner of the big square. Twist a chain of the next three bubbles. As you can see, we make the biggest square working our way around the small center square. Lock the free end of the chain of the last three bubbles between the next two bubbles in the center of the square. Be careful when you pull balloon through the loop of bubbles. Bubbles may untwist if you don't hold them or pull the balloon in wrong direction. That's what happened here. It's not hard to fix it, just twist it back. Though I wouldn't waste my time on it if I hold the bubbles properly, right? Keep in mind that we work on big sculpture, we have to twist over 100 bubbles. Time is important matter. Twist a chain of the next three bubbles. Lock the free end of the chain of the last three bubbles between the next two bubbles in the center of the square. We have made the third corner of the square. Twist a chain of the next three bubbles. It takes 16 bubbles to make this square. Lock the free end of the chain of the last three bubbles between the next two bubbles at the center of the square. We actually lock both ends of the chain of the first 16 bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made a square piece of fabric. Cut off the rest of the balloon. I do it with my fingers, you can do it with scissors. Tie off the ends. Alright, now you have to make one more square piece of fabric the same size, do it in the same fashion. And then we will make two more rectangular pieces. To make a rectangular piece, inflate a balloon leaving about 8-inch flat tail. We have to twist 24 bubbles to make this piece. Let's twist a chain of the first 6 bubbles. Today we will make a rectangle a bit differently, not like we made it in previously published instruction Fabric 6, Flex 2. We will do it in the same fashion as we did the square piece. Here's the chain of the first 6 bubbles. Let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 2 bubbles. And now we lock both ends of the chain of the first 8 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the small rectangle. It is the center part of our big rectangle. Twist a chain of the next 3 bubbles. Lock the free end of the chain of the last 3 bubbles between the nearest 2 bubbles of the small rectangle. Here you can see as I hold the bubbles to prevent untwisting. We just made the first corner of the big rectangle. Now we twist the chain of the next 2 bubbles. In this way we're going to work around the small rectangle. Like the free end of the chain of the last two bubbles, between the third and the fourth bubble, we have made the middle side of the big rectangle. Now we twist the chain of the next three bubbles. Like the free end of the chain of the last three bubbles, between the nearest two bubbles of the small rectangle, or at the center of the rectangle. We have made the second corner of the big rectangle. I'm going to first play this part of the video. We work the rest part of the rectangle in the same fashion. Twist the chain of the next three bubbles, lock the free end between the next two bubbles at the center. Twist the chain of the next two bubbles, lock the free end of the chain of the last two bubbles. Twist the chain of the next three bubbles. At the end we lock both ends of the chain of the first 24 bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations! We have made the rectangular piece. Cut off the rest of the balloon. Use your fingers or do it with the scissors. It's up to you. Tie off the ends. So again, we have made a rectangle, and previously we did the square. The rest of our sculpture we will work in the same fashion as we did in instruction fabric 6, flex 2. So here we inflate two balloons leaving about 8-inch flat tails. Tie the nozzles in one knot. We're going to use these two yellow balloons to make cross-like shape and to connect two squares and two rectangles to make the flag of Sweden. It makes no difference where we're going to start from. Alright, let's connect the squares together first, and then we will attach the rectangles. Twist the first yellow bubble, lock the free end of the first yellow bubble between two bubbles at the corner of the square. It does take time to make this sculpture. It's always faster and easier to work with bigger size bubbles. Okay, now we work with the second yellow balloon. Twist the first yellow bubble of the second balloon. Lock the free end of the first bubble of the second balloon between two bubbles at the corner of the square. Make sure to place the squares against each other, a mirror reflection position. Just like that. Now we twist the second yellow bubbles. And we lock the free ends of the second yellow bubbles in one lock twist. In this fashion we work to the next corner of the square. I'm going to first play this part of the video. Once we reach the corner of the square, we have to twist the fourth yellow bubbles and lock the free ends in one lock twist. Now we work our way around the corner of the square. Twist the fifth and the sixth yellow bubbles. Lock the free end of the chain of the last two yellow bubbles between the nearest two blue bubbles of the square. We work the second yellow balloon in the same fashion, working around the second square. Work each yellow balloon to the next corner of the square. Again, I'm going to first play this part of the video. Once we reach the next corner of the square, we have to twist the 9th and the 10th yellow bubbles. Now we lock the free end of the chain of the last two yellow bubbles at the corner between the two bubbles on the short side of the rectangle. It's important to place the rectangle properly against the square. That's it. Now we have to work this yellow balloon along the short side of the rectangle to the next corner of the rectangle. Then we will use the second yellow balloon to attach the second rectangle. We do it in the same fashion as we attached the first rectangle. Now we work this yellow balloon along the short side of the rectangle to the next corner of the rectangle. When we reach the corner, we have to twist the 14th yellow bubbles on both balloons. Lock the three ends of both 14th bubbles in one lock twist. And now we work the rest of the yellow balloons to the corner of the rectangle along the long side of the rectangle. No more turns. We work straight forward to the finish line. Once we get to the end, we cut off the rest of the yellow balloons, tie off the ends, and it would be it. We twisted 120 bubbles to make this sculpture. The fabric can be used to make different sculptures. In this example, I use it to make a flag. Congratulations! We have made flag of Sweden. Have fun and happy twisting!